When you think about the industry in the Los Angeles area, you probably think about Hollywood movies and actors and red carpets. But the LA area is home to 12,000 manufacturers who employ 500,000 people. It's the largest manufacturing center in the country. Make in LA is an accelerator, a hub supporting and investing in manufacturing startups that create hardware or physical devices that could be the next big idea in tech.
Are these functional prototypes?
Actually, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, so they're
This is what a manufacturing brain trust looks like. One person leading that trust is Carmen Palafox.
What exactly is an accelerator?
The accelerator part is a four-month program. So it's meant to take a hardware startup and speed up time, get them to the next level. They can use rapid prototyping equipment, 3D printers, laser cutters, injection molding machines.
So you literally give them the tools?
We give them the tools, we give them the training, we give them the access.
These are the new ones. So you saw the old one, mm-hmm. where it's kind of like boxy.
Make in LA has invested in 15 teams so far. They invest up to $150,000 in the first 4 months, plus additional capital reserved for the next phase.
It's thrilling. I'm constantly introduced to founders that are working on very interesting projects.
Founders like Gabe Grifoni, who started Rufus, a company specializing in wearable technology.
The purpose of this is for workers in construction or third-party logistics, warehousing, to wear this device. And in the background, what we're doing is understanding the behavior of the worker.
Why did you go to Make in LA? How did that happen?
You know, we're based out of Los Angeles, and it was really, one, nice to find an accelerator that's focused on hardware, because that's pretty rare. They have the mentors, the resources, and all these things that can kind of help us get there. It was really important as a hardware company to get that stuff right.
Gabe's passion for manufacturing isn't new. It's been a family business. His grandfather opened a hardware store in 1904.
I grew up doing inventory, taking stock, taking deliveries from UPS on the loading dock, all that kind of stuff. So I guess my roots are there.
Rufus currently has 50 enterprise customers in their pipeline with 2,000 units pre-ordered. But for that to happen, he and his team had to get past Sean Arora and the extremely intense training at Make in LA.
I am the instigator at Make in LA. I push these entrepreneurs to learn and grow very, very quickly. I am making them question everything that they thought they knew about the product, forcing them to look at it from various eyes. There's been so many tears shed in this program. I don't know, like hard is different for a lot of people.
First, we gotta kind of lay the groundwork.
Entrepreneurs come in weekly and share their war stories. And that's helped a lot of entrepreneurs avoid mistakes.
Both Carmen and Sean say they get a thrill out of finding and pushing the next wave of hardware entrepreneurs.
When I look at entrepreneurs, I overlook the stuff that generally biases investors. Are they a minority? Are they a woman? Do they have a stutter? Whatever it is that causes an investor to pass, we are able to look beyond that. We're not looking for a replica of today's great successes. We're looking for tomorrow's great successes.
If I'm successful, I create jobs, I create new ways to see the world, I create opportunities for people in my community.
So pressure's on.
The pressure's on.